the morning wake up water cooler.
It's now 9:04. It's official, and we're going to get started with Jake Chisholm and Shaun McClain from Jake and Shaun's Big Gay Affair with us on the water cooler today, talking about some of the biggest hits that rock the LGBTQ plus world over the years, and we'll be playing those hits as well. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Happy Pride Week.
Happy Pride.
All right, Jake, you sent me a list. I've got the songs ready. Are you ready to do this?
I'm so ready to do this. And okay. This is only like a sample. Like, there's so many. Like, I think there was like 50-something songs that we had wrote down. Then we had to go, okay, well, we have to narrow that down. So, yeah.
Because we only have an hour.
We only have an hour.
Yeah. Okay. So what are we going to start with?
Okay, this one, 1978. It sold 14 million copies, actually, which is kind of huge.
It was in my time, so I remember this song. I remember Boogie into this song.
Okay.
Yeah, Copa Key West.
Nice.
Even still to say, it's so relevant, and people have a great time with it. So it's I Will Survive, Gloria Gaynor.
Yes, Gaynor. On 94.1 East Coast FM.
Morning Wake Up Water Cooler, 94.1 East Coast FM.
Yeah.
On 94.1 East Coast FM, Jake and Shaun are with us this morning, just playing some ABBA there with Dancing Queen. And 1976, that song came out.
Yeah, I feel like a dancing queen this morning. No,
just back from...
You know what's funny? That song was actually ABBA's only number one hit in the U.S.
Really?
Which is hard to believe. Like, everybody knows their songs, and that was the only one that went number one in the
U.S. But I think everybody knows their songs now because of Mamma Mia.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Yeah, that's partly it. That's partly it. I came back from Mamma Mia in New York City and was playing the Mamma Mia album in the car, and my boss was with me at the time. She goes, "That music's really good." I go, "Yeah, it is."
You know why? Because ABBA doesn't have a bad song.
No.
That's true.
They're all awesome.
Yeah.
And they got
Waterloo.
Oh, or The Winner. If you want something a little more, you know, cerebral, The Winner Takes It All. Nothing better than The Winner Takes It All. Yeah. And they've got two new tunes coming out. They're reuniting ABBA after, 1982 was the last time they appeared in public together.
Now, I think Mamma Mia is on in Halifax again, is it not?
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
Is it?
But the Charlottetown show was like
the Charlottetown Festival, they packed the crowds in over there.
It was amazing.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Okay, so from ABBA to Sylvester... So let's talk about this song.
1978.
He was amazing. I remember Sylvester. I mean, that was in the day, but of course, Sylvester passed during the AIDS epidemic, right? He was one of the people who, like, there was a lot of really cool stars that left us at that time, and Sylvester was one of those. But in his day, he was the king.
Well, you know, Jake had sent me the list, and I saw Sylvester, and I'm like, I don't know if I know that song. And as soon as I listened to it, I'm like, of course I know this song.
Oh, it's such a good groove.
It's called You Make Me Feel on 94.1 East Coast FM.
We're on the dancing. The best music mix with an East Coast twist. 94.1 East Coast FM.
My mama told me when I was young, we're all on superstars. She rolled my hair, put my lipstick on, in a glass of her boudoir. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are, she said, 'cause he made you perfect, babe. So hold your head up, girl, and you'll go far. Just be a queen. Don't be a drag. Just be a queen. Don't be a drag. Just be a queen. Give yourself prudence and love your friends, so we can rejoice the truth. In the religion of the insecure, I must be myself, respect my youth. A different law is not.
Queen, whether you're broke or evergreen, your black, white, beige, Chola descent, your Lebanese, your Orient. Whether life's disabilities left you outcast or leader teased, rejoice and love yourself today, 'cause baby, you were born this way.
No matter gay, straight or bi, lesbian, transgender life, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born to survive. No matter black, white, or beige, Chola or Orient made, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born to be brave.
Lady Gaga and Born This Way on 94.1 East Coast FM, hanging out around the water cooler with Jake Chisholm and Shaun McLean from Jake and Shaun's Big Gay Affair. And let me tell you something. Way back in the day, Shaun and I, we did one of the first water coolers together, ever.
The first.
The first.
Yes.
Yes. He started it all. This is very exciting. Let's talk about Gaga, because she is amazing.
Yeah. Well, and I think she came in at a really interesting time, too, in pop culture, that she just exploded, you know, the gay community into pop culture again and made it mainstream media. You know, that hadn't happened, and I don't think, in that capacity before. So it was pretty neat when she came on the scene. And just the whole, you know, gender rules and the outfits and the creativity.
The dress made of meat.
Yeah, like, it was, everything was so iconic. So,
yeah.
Yeah.
Did you ever have a meat dress, Jake?
No, but I'm thinking this weekend.
Maybe a nice pork chop? Like a bikini with pork chops?
Yeah.
And a hamburger?
Yeah.
Well, you know, the pork shop's one of our new sponsors here.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah,
we'll
so
them.
We'll go
oh
to the
God.
We'll get
There's
the pork shop in on that.
Perfect.
And we'll get Anne with bacon, just like lines of bacon.
There we go.
Yep.
You're like a shimmy dress.
And I'll wear beef.
Perfect.
Good.
So from Lady Gaga to Madonna.
Exactly. And Madonna, I mean, you can speak on her more than I can, but I mean...
I knew her well. Me and Madonna were like that.
But Madonna, so this next song kind of came from the underground world of gay culture. It was from the Harlem House Ball in New York City. This is where voguing came from.
I love that you know all that. Harlem House Balls. How did you know that?
What? Well, it's called Google.
You worship it. That it's yes, dear Google.
Dear Google. Yeah. No, and there's actually a documentary on the underground voguing culture.
People used to go to church, and now there's Google.
And now there's Google. No, it was. It's really cool because the voguing was.
Love you, Google.
Oh my God, I can't stand you. No, voguing.
Is this what the show is like?
This is what our everyday is like.
I like the old Italian lady that goes Google. Hello, Google.
Anyways, Madonna Vogue is insane, and she was like the precursor to Lady Gaga.
And that was before Google.
That was before
Madonna. Very true.
Madonna did it before Google.
Yes, she did. Yes. Okay, well, let's strike a pose. Here's Madonna and Vogue on 94.1 East Coast FM.
We'll be right back. magazine, on the cover of a magazine. Grace Kelly, Harlow Jean, picture of a beauty queen. Jean Kelly, Fred Astaire, Ginger Rogers, dance on air. They had style, they had grace. Rita Hayworth gave good face. Lauren Catherine Manitou, Betty Davis, we love you. Ladies with an attitude, fellas that were in the mood. Don't just stand there, let's get to it. Strike a pose.
Madonna and Vogue on 94.1 East Coast FM. It's 9:28. We do have a check of the County Crier coming up. Lots of activities on the go this week in the community. But we're hanging out right now around the water cooler with Jake and Shaun. And we're talking about the music, some of the biggest hits that rock the LGBTQ world over the years, plus world over the years. And there's so much from, like, the earlier part, like, say, the 70s all the way to current, and then we're kind of back to the 90s. We're here, there, and everywhere. So up next, we have RuPaul.
Oh, RuPaul. I mean, he brought...
Is he or she?
Well, he identifies as a he.
Oh, is he? Okay.
He brought drag culture to mainstream. I mean, especially with this next song, like... It was, no one else had ever done it before, ever. Like, it was so huge when it came out. And then came out in 1993. It was mass, like, and the deals that he got, like MAC and Cosmetics, and now he's got a TV show, and it was huge. It means a lot to a lot of people that he paved the way for them. It's huge. Yeah, no one can deny that. That RuPaul is definitely...
This is a big song.
This is a big song.
Huge. Yeah. So are we ready for some Supermodel?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. Let's here do on 94.1 East Coast FM.
Once upon a time, there was a little black girl in the Brewster Projects of Detroit, Michigan. At 15, she was spotted by an Ebony Fashion Fair talent scout, and her modeling career took off.
You better work.
Turn to the I have one thing to say. You better work.
94.1 East Coast FM. It's Raining Men, the Weather Girls, and we have Jake and Shaun actually just giving us a little bit of background on that song and something I never realized.
Yeah, because Sylvester that we mentioned earlier, he was like the king, and the Weather Girls were his backup singers. So I'm not sure if they broke away from Sylvester. Yeah, I think they did, actually. They broke away from Sylvester, and then they recorded that, and that became like this massive hit as well, right?
I don't know anything else from the Weather Girls, but I love that song.
Oh, I know that song.
And the greatest video, eh?
Oh, the video is so much fun. It is insane. It's so bad, but so good at the, all at the same time. And it's one of those ones that it's just like one of those iconic music videos that will just stand the test of time.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's hilarious. I love that song.
We have one more break. Actually, a couple more breaks. We have a couple more songs to get to. Yes, actually, we have three more songs to get to. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so we have to get to it. We're going to take a quick break, and then we're going to hear from Diana Ross. I'm Coming Out next.
The Morning Wake Up Water Cooler, 94.1 East Coast FM. We'll be right back.
94.1 East Coast FM with Diana Ross, and I'm coming out. It's 9:47, and we've been chatting with Jake and Shaun, so obviously, big song.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. I'm coming out. She actually wrote that in support of LGBTQ community.
See, I never forgave her for leaving the Supremes. I'm still mad at Diana. No, if you're listening, Diana.
I'm coming out. I mean, it's about actually, like, coming out. Like, it's about...
Just like the title says.
Yeah. It's about acceptance and being yourself.
So
and,
did she come out?
Oh, maybe she did. Oh. Ooh, that's going to break
there's a
people.
Breaking story.
Yeah, People Magazine, call us.
Yeah, no, Diana will be calling saying, I did not come out.
No. She, I mean, and also, like, just, like, her appearance, too, like, the hair and the outfits. Yeah. She's one of the queens of gay culture.
I have to tell you, I went to her show at the, what's that center in Toronto with the big dome?
ACC?
Yeah. Her reunion tour of yes. Diana Ross
what?
And the Supremes.
Amazing.
And it was amazing.
I bet.
And you want to talk confetti cannons, honey, let me tell you.
Oh.
Yeah.
Do you guys have any confetti cannons in the show?
We do, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it depends on the show, but I definitely want them to be at the DeKosh show. Yeah. Because there's nothing more exciting than...
Yes.
Confetti cannons.
We're going to be talking about the DeKosh show in just a little bit. We have to get two more songs on here, though. So we have Robin, Dancing on My Own. Tell me about this one.
This one, now I think it's most famous for the Callum Scott version. This actually was written by Robin, and she's a lesbian, and she wrote the song about having someone that isn't really out. You know, and that toying around and love. And this is big for, I mean, typically I think we always see more songs that relate to gay men. So this was really awesome to see a song go big for the female side of the world.
Here's Robin, Dancing on My Own on 94.1 East Coast FM.
Stupid, but you just gotta see it for myself.
94.1 East Coast FM.
.1 East Coast FM with Culture Club and Karma Chameleon. Number one back in 1983. I know, Shaun, you must remember that.
I do. I was trying to think where I was in 83. I think I was in Halifax. Yeah.
Yeah. Boy George, I mean, he's still going strong.
Oh.
But he destroyed every gender norm that you could even think of. Like, he totally crossed boundaries. And in that time, like 80s, 90s,
yeah.
Like that's big.
He wasn't a drag queen. He was like a radical fairy or something.
Yeah, like yeah. he was himself. Yeah, and I think now, like, I think like even like current day 2018, it's just now becoming somewhat normal to see people that are like Boy George, like that's how they dress, and it's awesome. He paved the way. There's so many of them. It's
they
insane.
Just don't care.
No, they don't.
Like you.
Exactly.
Oh, you too.
Oh, girl.
Listen,
oh, girl.
We have to give a little plug here, a promo for your show coming up. It is called Jake and Shaun's Big Gay Affair. If you've not seen it yet, now, by
and
all
you
accounts,
have to come.
I know.
You have to come.
I do, and I was away last time, but everybody I've talked to has said how amazing the show is and funny. And we got a little taste of it this morning. Tell us about the show and when the next one's coming up.
Okay, well, the next show is locally is October 27th at the DeCoste Center.
Yep.
In Pictou.
Tickets are on sale.
Tickets are on sale.
And don't
now.
Wait to get
no,
tickets.
No, actually, no, it's very flattering, and we want to say thank you very much to everybody who do support us, because tickets have sold a lot, actually. There's not a whole lot left.
And for an October show in Pictou County,
I know,
because we're last
it's
minute.
Very flattering, so we thank you very much. But no, the show, it's a mixture of...
Mad TV.
Yeah, like Mad TV skits.
Saturday Night Live.
We write all of our own material, and then there's a lot of music, and there's big video screens, and confetti cannons, and lasers, and it's just, it's cool. It's like a rock concert meets theater meets...
Betty Lou and Linda.
Yeah. It's fabulous. It's a lot of fun. It's coming out and having a big party for 2 hours, and you leave just with, like, vibrating with emotions.
And joy.
And joy.
Yeah.
Pride and joy.
And why wouldn't you want to feel like that?
Exactly.
Right?
It's so much fun.
Awesome. Thanks for being here. This is a
thank
lot of fun.
You.
Happy Pride
fun.
Week.
Happy Pride, Ann. Thanks for
great
having us.
Great way to kick things
thanks,
off. And don't forget, the flag raising will be happening at 12 noon at the Riverfront Gazebo. We've got a full list of events for Pride Week. Share it to our Facebook page, facebook.com/941 East Coast FM.